We've just learned a bunch of laws for computing limits, but unfortunately, usually limits are not given in exactly the form that one we could apply one of these laws. One example of a kind of limit that you might see would be a limit that looks like this. Limit as x goes to 2 of x squared minus 4 over x minus 2. In this limit, if we're trying to use the limit laws, we would split it apart and we would have limit as x goes to 2 on the top of x squared minus 4 divided by the limit as x goes to 2 on the bottom of x minus 2. And each of these limits we can split apart farther using the limit laws. And if we do that, we're going to see that we're going to have limit on as x goes to 2 of x squared on top minus limit as x goes to 2 of 4 divided by limit as x goes to 2 of x minus limit as x goes to 2 of 2. And I think that we can evaluate each of these limits at this point. So the limit as x goes to 2 of x squared is going to be 4. The limit as x goes to 2 of 4, well, that's just a constant, so it's 4, divided by the limit as x goes to 2 of x is 2, minus the limit as x goes to 2 of 2, that's a constant, so it's going to be 2. So what we get here is 0 over 0. So 0 over 0, what does that mean? What is that telling us? Well, first of all, is 0 over 0 a number? And the answer is no. We can't divide by 0, right? That's not a number. So does 0 over 0 mean the answer is undefined? Again, the answer here is no. Now, up until this point in your life, 0 over 0 or dividing by 0 has always meant something was undefined. But now we're doing limits. We're not plugging in. So if somebody were to ask me for the function f of x equals x squared minus 4 over x minus 2, what is f of 2? I would definitely say it's undefined. But if somebody asked me what is the limit as x approaches 2 of x squared minus 4 over x minus 2, that's a trickier question. Because now we're asking what's happening around 2, but not exactly at 2. Can we plug in points that are near 2 here? Yes, we can. So we should be able to find this limit. And in fact, if we look at this function graphically, it turns out it looks like a straight line with a hole in it at 2. And how would I know that? Well, x squared minus 4 over x minus 2 can be simplified. I can factor the top into x minus 2, x plus 2 divided by x minus 2. And now you can see the same factor in the top and the bottom. And immediately you want to cancel those x minus 2s, right? And you want to say that f of x is equal to x plus 2. And it is. Sort of. You see, this isn't really f of x. Let's call it g of x. It's a new function. G of x is the function x plus 2. It's the function that has exactly this line with no hole in it. But since we have a hole in our function at 2, f of x isn't exactly the same. It has a different domain, different x values you're allowed to plug into it. So g of x is equal to f of x. Except when x equals 2. What does that mean for us and our limit? Well, if we're trying to take the limit as x goes to 2 of x squared minus 4 over x minus 2, we don't care about the point 2, right? We don't care about what happens at 2. We care about what happens nearby. So when doing limits, we are allowed to do this simplification of canceling a factor out of the top and the bottom. So we can say that the limit as x goes to 2 of our original function is the same as the limit as x goes to 2 of our new reduced function x plus 2. But that's a function we can use the limit laws on. So limit as x goes to 2 of x plus limit as x goes to 2 of 2 gives me 2 plus 2, which is 4. And this is kind of interesting because f of 2 is undefined, but the limit as x approaches 2 of f is 4. And the main thing to take away from here is that you can factor and cancel terms. When taking a limit. And what else you want to take away from this is if you get a form, so that's what we call the answers to these limits that aren't actually numbers, so a form of 0 over 0, you want to cancel something. So depending on the difficulty of the problem, it may be harder than just factoring something out and canceling it. There may be more algebra involved, but you always can find some way of canceling if you're getting 0 over 0. So the moral here is we want to do more algebra. And as we continue on the lesson, we'll see some of the more difficult types of algebra that you might have to do.